Father, I don't ask you to take my followers out of the world, but keep them safe from the evil one. They don't belong to this world, and neither do I. Your word is the truth. So let this truth make them completely yours. I am sending them into the world just as you sent me. I have given myself completely for their sake, so that they may belong completely to the truth. I'm not praying just for these followers. I'm also praying for everyone else who will have faith because of what my followers will say about me. I want all of them to be one with each other, just as I am one with you and you are one with me. I also want them to be one with us. Then the people of this world will believe that you sent me. I have honored my followers in the same way that you honored me, in order that they may be one with each other, just as we are one. I am one with them, and you are one with me, so that they may become completely one. Then this world's people will know that you sent me. They will know that you love my followers as much as you love me. Those words come from John 17, verses 15 to 23. How much do you love your children? Well, who can answer that question without going beyond human ability? My mother would always say, I love you more than words can tell. Well, indeed, my mother's love was not just words. She loved me with sacrifice every day. I remember when we had one chicken to divide among our family of four, including two teenage boys. My mother would often say that her favorite piece of chicken was the back. Well, the back, of course, had almost no meat on it. If God loves you as much as he loves Jesus, what could that mean? Well, it means that God loves you more than words can tell. Some have said the Bible is a love letter from God. It is that, of course. But if all you have is a love letter, or even 66 love letters, you may still indeed be sad. A love letter without a living relationship with the author of the letter is empty. The love letter of God is written by the Holy Spirit. And that same Holy Spirit also comes to live in your heart. And the one who loves you leads and guides you every day. He is able to empower you to live a life that is amazing to those who do not know God. So let your mind pause for a moment and ponder that God the Father loves you like he loves Jesus. And his love is in word and in deed. Lord Jesus, thank you for paying the price that it took to redeem me from the world and the sin that had me in chains. Thank you for loving me more than words can tell. Praise your holy name now and forever. Amen.